I really didn't want to make this video, but I feel I have to. I don't mind making this video, but I shouldn't even have to make this video, because what I'm sharing now should be obvious to you by now, especially if you've been following my channel for a while. Or if you're older than 25, or if you're in your 30s. Some people get this at a young age already. Not everyone wants to be real. I'm not talking about people so-called being themselves and all of that. I'm talking about being realistic, really realistic. Some folks, I'm saying quite some folks, want to be cynical, pessimistic with facts. They look at bad facts, which are real facts, and they point them out and potential bad outcomes, and they're at ease with that. They have no intention whatsoever in solutions, nor in possible improvement, even if possible improvement may require short-term suffering. I'm telling you, some folks are happy. Not really happy, but they're comfortable being in such a cynical, pessimistic way of thinking and relating to one another. Then you have people who don't want to face any bad facts. Well, bad facts. They don't want to face any facts that relate to bad stuff because they can't handle it. That's another form of denial. You have the cynical, pessimistic form of denial in which you do recognize facts, but you don't want to look beyond, so you remain stuck in the negative. And then you have folks who don't want to see any negative. That's the other side of it, but it's both denial. And then you have folks who just get along, become apathetic towards the world around them, and only concern themselves with their own so-called business. All three forms are really denial. It's just denial with multiple faces. But then you have the folks that look beyond, that look at the bigger picture, and that will find out that negativity isn't really that big, it's just people making it big because they agree with it. And such folks will see a lot of beautiful possibilities and opportunities around them, and that's a good thing. But they'll also see the persistence of worldly people in holding on to denial. And such folks that look at the bigger picture, they'll be quite realistic in what they expect from others. They'll see people for what they are. Not what they think they are, but what they are. And they understand very well that fighting negativity can make you negative, also can draw you in the negative. They do combat the negativity, but realize they need to be wiser. And sooner or later, they'll find out they need Christ, because they can't do it by their own human strength. Such folks are real. But let me tell you, most folks don't want to be real. I can make this video very long, giving parables, but I just flat out tell it to you. Most folks don't want to be real. Talk about most folks you will encounter. They just want relief, just want to be at ease. They don't want to examine anything. They don't want to process anything. I'm being factual here with you. The earlier, or I'm going to say the sooner you realize this, the better it is for you. Then you won't waste moments of your life trying to convince people to see the obvious. Well, it should be obvious to you that they obviously don't want to see the obvious because they are comfortable being in denial. Straight up. Okay. Let me give a parable just in case, so to put this in context. And this parable, it's just a parable, okay? There are more ways this can work out. Let's say now you have a chick who often goes to pubs just to get the company of her friends. She's really lonely. She has no real friends, but she just wants to have company. As human being, you need that. Then one day she meets a guy at college whom she falls in love with. I'm not going to make this too long. But then she meets his relatives. And some of his relatives are a bit, they're a bit self-righteous towards her, saying that she's a chick that often goes to pubs, so they have a self-righteous attitude that she's dirty, blah, blah, blah. But her boyfriend doesn't matter. He doesn't care what his relatives say. But then, the boyfriend then checks out her family background, and he sees very disturbing stuff. He sees a grandmother that seems jealous of her granddaughter. And the grandmother even looked at in a lustful manner towards the guy, and the guy was quite disturbed by it. When he mentioned it to his girlfriend, she shrugged it off. She thought, dude, you're going too far. A woman in her 70s looking such a way to you, come on, that doesn't exist. The boyfriend then points out to her that her father often spoke in a negative manner towards her. For example, if she forgot to pick up her phone, he could say to her, Jessica, don't you forget something? And Jessica would think, she would ask, oh yeah, my phone. It could have gone that way. Or he could have said, Jessica, I think you forget your phone. But no, he would often say, look, if you forget your phone and people can contact you, your problem, bad stuff may happen to you, and all of that. The boyfriend pointed out to her that the way her father was addressing her was abnormal, disturbing, and it was a form of witchcraft. When she heard all of this, she broke contact with the guy for a few days, but afterwards she contacted him again on WhatsApp and she apologized, and she recognized he was telling the truth. That the way her father addressed her indeed didn't add up. And then she confessed another thing, that she realized that most of her relatives talk bad about her parents, but that her parents still kept those people in their lives. And then the boyfriend asked her, Jessica, why are your parents keeping those people in their lives if they keep speaking bad about them? And so the boyfriend found out that the parents of this girl were really into witchcraft, and they were bewitching the family to cover them up. The relatives, some of them weren't aware they were into witchcraft, but they kept cooperating with the couple anyway, because they would go to the couple for advice and the couple would help them, but the couple wouldn't reveal unto them that it was through paranormal aid. And the relatives were unthankful. They were toxic. But the couple were operating in witchcraft. They fed off their toxicity. And the father redirected his dissatisfaction towards his daughter. And that's why the daughter had difficulty bonding with friends in general, because she had this discontent that was programmed into her by her father. And she often went to pubs and parties just to have people around her. She thought that was the way to do stuff. It was after her boyfriend revealed onto her how disturbing her father's attitude was that she began to heal, that she began to realize, hold on a minute, this shouldn't be like this. Well, in this case, in this parable, the individual was at the receiving end of the negativity, realized that, hold on a minute, they shouldn't be like this. An individual made the right decision to look for safety and to look for a way out. But there are times, let's take another case in which the target did not look for safety because the target didn't want to be real. Let's say that same guy now, instead of meeting this Jessica, met a chick called Mandy. I'm just thinking of a name. Or, well, whatever name you use, Brenda or whatever. He met another chick, but this chick didn't want to see it. What would happen now? For her to remain in denial, she will have to pretend as if her so-called life is great. So she will downplay everything the guy tells her. And she will complain about him revealing all the stuff with her friends. And her friends were also in denial, will think that guy is just crazy. Sooner or later, the parents will find out that target their daughter, whom they target, and is involved with a guy that opens their eyes. Now, those narcissists don't want to lose their supply, so they then will talk to the daughter and try to convince her that the guy isn't good for her. But not only that, those narcissists will also make that guy their target now, because he exposed them. They will have narcissistic rage against the guy. Or it may end up that the chick itself may decide to seek relief with another guy and then complain about the previous guy she was with. And the previous guy now get the rage of that other guy who's like an Ahab, who wants approval at all costs. So just realize the following. Some folks don't want to be real. It is not a surprise that most of the homicides and, intense crimes, like things like kidnapping, rape, or what, all those things category, it's not a coincidence nor a surprise that most of such crimes happen between people who know one another. I'm telling you, a lot of folks don't want to be real. And if you're the one being real, recognize that you're the one being real. And recognize also when it's obvious that others obviously don't want to be real. And relate to them in a practical manner. Because you need to relate to people, you need to be around people. You can't just remove yourself to some distant, uninhabited Pacific island, no. You relate to other people, but relate to them in a wise manner. If someone doesn't want to be real, stop sharing real stuff with them. If they don't want to be real, what are they going to do with the real stuff you're going through? Or the real stuff that you're busy with? That you're involved with, I mean. I'm telling you, look at the bigger picture. That's all for now. A great Christ, and be at peace.